So we've, we kind of had something for everyone this year at Midnight Madness. We had some actual big game. We had some hip-hop Yakuza martial arts with Tokyo Tribe. We had What the Fuck with Tusk. I don't even know how where that goes. So something for everyone. And of course, we've had a little bit of subtle horror with It Follows, but now we get the intense adrenaline horror with Rec 4 Apocalypse. Tomorrow night, we will be introducing you to a first-time director from Belgium. This marks our first Flemish-language film in Midnight Madness, and I believe the director of Club is here in the house. Jonas, where are you? Stand up, Jonas. Where are you? Right here! The director of Club for tomorrow night! And on Thursday night, we have our own Canadian production of The Editor, the guys from Astron 6 who brought you Fauna and Endor, the New Zealand Vampires from Club. What we do with the Shadows, New Zealand Vampires, and then we'll round it all off with the homecoming of the team that brought you Your Next with The Guest! I'd also like to tell you a little bit about the Vampire program, because we have some other kind of fun, horror-related, kind of creepy, weird films in the Vanguard selection. There's still chances to see a film by a director who wasn't in Midnight Madness with Cal Bear, Fabrice de Welts' Alleluia. We have a film which is produced by the director of Witching and Bitching from last year, Shrew's Nest. We have a really special film called Spring. For anyone who felt that what was missing from Before Sunrise was a supernatural edge, Spring. How many people saw Spring? Go see it. Really fun. And then, of course, Midnight Madness Bad Boy is in Vanguard, Takeshi Miike with Over Your Dead Body. It's my great pleasure to introduce to you not only the director of Rec 4 Apocalypse, Shelby Ballinaro, but also for the first time to meet her fans. She's never come to North America before, the star of Rec 1, Rec 2, and Rec 4, Manuela Mascaro.
Angela next save the world, but here's the editor, for Johnny Ballinaro, the director of Rec 4
Okay, so first off, I want to ask, with this installment, you chose to abandon the POV storytelling. Can you talk about why you chose that?
Well, we used it in the first one, the second one, and I decided it was enough. I was not interested to repeat myself once again. And I think the audience deserves something different. Because we explore possibilities of the subjective camera, and we did it. It's done.
Now, when you made the first film, you never expected that there'd be three more installments. At what point was this part of the origin story of the host of the possession thought out?
When we made the first movie, it was just an experiment. We didn't know exactly what we were making, and we didn't know even if the movie would be released in theaters or even in DVD. And sadly, the film worked and people liked it, and it was a huge success. And then we decided to make the second one. And yeah, stop. But what they decided was back, because we were always thinking about the possibilities of the plot, of the story. And with Paco, we decided to make two last movies, the Wreck 3 Genesis and Apocalypse. Paco did Wreck 3 and I was for I don't know. And now it's the end. I am the final. It could be more, because now the two characters, Nick and Angela, fighting against the whole ocean. Very, very attractive, but I said it was the end, so now I can't. I said when we made the wreck, the first one, and journalists asked us, it's going to be a sequel? No, absolutely no, it's a sequel.
Now, this was a very different role for you. Because it's much more action-driven, and I understand that 80% of it was shot on a real boat. Can you talk about the difficulty of the transition from the first film to running, jumping, screaming?
I'm shocked now. It's the first time, as I told you, that I see a film, and it's really difficult to see a film where you are in. It's like, what is this? Okay, the question. The boat was a nightmare. I think the real experience is worse than the film. You know? It was so horrible. The place was disgusting. It was a fishing boat, a real one, and a very old one, and it was abandoned. And we had all these creepy fish, like pudriéndose, like fish, like smelling really, really bad. It was all rusty, full of oxygen, and from the very first day, when we shot the first day was this scene where I'm escaping in stairs, narrow stairs, and I have monkeys. There were no monkeys, so, obviously. And I got a lot of rashes and blood, and I had to go to the hospital the first day for the tetanus. And then I had to go to the hospital every day because I was getting hurt all the time from all these huge men that I hate them so much. Wow. They survive almost until the end, and you kill like very nice people at the beginning. Why do you do that? Wow, I'm so angry now. Yeah.
I decided to show in this real boat. There were no, when she was getting the stairs, there were no monkeys, there were rotten fishes around. And we decided to shoot it in a real and comfortable boat because we wanted to make the movie very physical. When they fight, one character fighting another, we're fighting not real.
Yes, real. We had choreographies, and when he saw it through the lens, he was like, "This is shit." If you have to stop her, you stop her for real. If you have to hit her, you hit her for real. And when you have to stay, you stay for real. They just don't do like.
If we have seven men trying to open this girl with a knife and take the world, the back of it. It's better to have seven men actually forcing her to stay in the jungle and actually she trying to escape. No, she playing.
Pretending that I escape.
No, because it's not a problem to try to keep her and she try to escape. It's a big mess. I mean, it's okay. Real.
You know what I'm really angry about that now that I just saw the film? The underwater scenes. We had such a horrible time. I had hypothermia. We had this ambulance coming because I was literally dying. Because we were shooting from in Spain, we were shot the film in Canary Islands. Canary Islands is like a very tropical place, like really nice and hot and warm. And we shot the film in July and August. But the underwater scenes, they decided to shoot it in Asturias, that is in the north of Spain, in November. Yeah. Why? And then we have like 20 seconds in the film, and it could be whoever in the world. Yeah. It didn't have to be me.
Waves, you know, this kind of pool. One was in Waterland, you know, with all his families, swimming, all these things. And the other one was a professional pool for training of rescue teams and all these things with wave 3 meters. And we decided to use this pool. But we could. Only use this one in November, and then we went in November.
Do we have any other questions from the audience here? Yes.
How does it feel to be on strength of Jamie?
This is a surprise to me. I was getting that from the journalist today. Like, how do you feel like, because these movies are like very popular here, and we didn't know. No, it's a surprise. So I'm amazed. It's like today, I feel like if I was giving someone else's life, you know, because it's like, oh, is this really happening? Like, it's great, it's really great. We did, as Jaume said, like the first film, we didn't expect it to be released. We thought we were doing something really weird. We had so much fun, but we were laughing like, no, nobody's gonna like this. No, nobody's gonna understand this. I always said like, maybe Korea. And DVD, no, like the cinemas. And then this is a huge surprise, or it's like, thank you.
Thank you. in.
But you didn't like me before. Yeah.
Well, because
that was really bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to direct because the actor doesn't get to
go. What are you doing right now? It's going to be on the stage play.
Yeah, I am on stage. And I'm in a TV series that is like very popular. Actually, when we were shooting this film, I was recording the TV series in Madrid. This was in Gran Canaria and Barcelona. And in the TV series is a 50s TV series. Like very, I'm a very rich girl and very posh. I was shooting in Madrid during the day. Being like very posh, very 50s, and then I took an AVE, a high speed train, and got to Barcelona. And I was doing this nighttime, and then I woke up and I took an AVE back to Madrid. I didn't sleep, and it was amazing. Like, wow, is this real life? Where am I?
We have another question from the audience.
Right here.
Yes, right there, yes.
Alright, first of all, welcome to Toronto.
Thank you! Thank you!
Did you hear your weekly tip? I'm not sure if you guys heard, but Today Vogue magazine named Queen Street West in Toronto the second most hip neighborhood in the world.
And what does that have to do with Rec Force?
Probably
not because they have a full Well, I'll explain to them, to the whole Queen Street phenomenon just later, don't worry. Alright, next question. Yes. Pressure's on, sir. You said Saw, but I've never shown any of the other Saw films. I would never do that to you.
A little bit more, and probably less than the third.
What was the question?
What was the hardest part and where was the most of the budget?
Okay. Okay. I think it was the renting of the ship. This is very complicated to use a ship in a port. A port is a known place with that they have their own rules, politics, and it's really disturbing. And you have to talk with them and have to write to deal with them. It's very difficult and expensive. Probably as well.
Okay, we'll do one more. Yes.
What did you think of Janet's Carpenter?
No.
I'm making sure.
We'll just ask you, you're not so much an actor, what was your impression of quarantine? Yes, quarantine. Is there quarantine?
I haven't seen it. I do like Jennifer Carpenter. I have seen it in Dexter. And I really like it. When I knew that she was playing the role, I was so flattered or like, oh my god, I really like this actress. But something curious happened. Yeah, we went to one festival with one or two, I don't remember. And Jaume Amundei, he told me, like, Manuela, come, I want to show you something in the computer. And he played something. And I was like, what is this? I mean, it's Rick, I've seen it like 500 times. And he said, like, look. And then I realized it was not me, but it was the same. So I was like, oh my god, what is this? Like, so I had the feeling that it was like exactly the same with a different actress. No? But she's really good. I think she's a great actress. Eh?